Aloha, everyone, and welcome to the Mad King Paradox's Pokemon Sun and Moon anime live reaction episode 13. Flubbed it up midway, caught it though. So, I turned on the light, so it won't be so bloody dark anymore. So, last episode. Yeah, I can see why people were talking about it. James caught a Marini, and Team Rocket finally beat Ash. If it weren't for Beware, that would have ended very badly. So, like I said in this marathon of episodes that I've done today, I'm still a little bit under the weather. So, hopefully with my new system, hopefully you all can see well. And hopefully I don't sound too bad, because you can tell I'm really congested at the moment. But enough about my problems. You're here for the live reaction of the episode. So please, open it up on another browser with whatever media site you prefer to use. And let us continue. Okay, they're watching something. Go back and forth. It's Bounsweet, hopping around with stuff on its head. Are those pancakes? Not exactly certain what it's doing either. It's just bouncing around with what looks like pancakes on its head. The race. Pokemon Pancake Race. Explain. So it's a festival-like event where one of the events is the pancake race. Interesting. So they're in a shop of some kind. With an Alolan Raichu. Huh. I was very iffy about Alolan Raichu when I first saw it, but it kind of grew on me. I mean, I'm glad that they gave it the psychic typing, because it just floating on its tail like that would make no sense otherwise. Makes wanting to evolve a Pikachu a lot more tempting now, doesn't it? That's a lot of pancakes. Well, why would you drop the pancakes? That's a perfectly good waste. And they already hate each other. They're just sitting there eating pancakes. Okay, Pikachu, you are at a very bad disadvantage, while Alolan Raichu has a very big advantage. That's, not good. And here's Team Rocket just sitting around. I was wondering if Team Rocket would be a part of this episode, because it kind of seems fillerish. So, all the preconceived notions about Raichu being slower than Pikachu are now thrown out the window because of Alolan Raichu. Because of the psychic ability it has. It seems smaller than a regular Raichu at that. I remember when they went up against Lieutenant Surge's Raichu, compared to Pikachu, that thing was massive. But I guess it being smaller and floating around on its tail would make it a lot quicker. Let me guess. Grand prize is a year's worth of pancakes, which makes Team Rocket want to enter. Free pancakes anywhere in the Alola region. Yep. Their stomachs are making them compete. Hello, Magnezone. Haven't seen a ride Pokemon like you before. And they're airing this on live television? I really shouldn't be surprised. Uphill, a balance beam. And then a wagon. Why would you use a Snorlax in the wagon? And then downhill. With moves being allowed. Or moves not being allowed, I should say. So pretty much everyone is involved. We know Mallow's is going to be Bounce Sweet. Oh, the egg is flashing. Who's everyone's partner going to be? Samson Oak? Wouldn't it be the Alolan Exeggutor? It's the only one I've ever seen him with. I'm assuming he's going to go with Charizard. Cocky's going to go with Charizard. Oh, so Cocky's using the fire turtle, whose name I still cannot think of. I like it, so I hate myself for not remembering its name. And the pancake race starts. All right. Right. Intermission should be finishing up any second. Yep, now we're back. So, I'm guessing all the ones that don't have balance are going to falter right away. Yep, like that guy just did. Then Team Rocket's gonna have something to do with the majority of the rest of them failing later on. And Sophocles is out. Hello, Alolan Muk. So the Alolan Muk eat all the pancakes that fall. I love Alolan Muk. So seeing them just anywhere is always gratifying to me. Mimikyu's holding it up with his tail. Well, like his stick tail, I should say. Mimikyu. You can't attack. So it looks like Jesse's fallen behind considerably. Yeah, Mimikyu, you can't attack Pikachu for the entirety of the race. Oh, that would be a problem. Oh, that would take so much self-restraint. Oi! Popplio! You shouldn't be allowed to do that with a bubble. On top of the bubble, yes, but not inside of the bubble. Oh, hello, Neckoala. I still think one of the funniest things about Neckoala is its shiny form. Oh, that's Samson's Pokemon. Okay. James? Why? You have a Marini. You have Meowth. You have Wobbuffet. Why are you having a mock beware with Meowth and Wobbuffet inside of it? And you made a poor choice as well. A giant, heavy fire turtle. And Cocky is down. Or. Yep, Cocky's out. Hello, random Sharpedo. And there's all the ones that are just like, I'm just waiting for my trainer to come on. Togedemaru is not happy. Mimikyu, you know you can't attack. So Mimikyu's going to attack with the camera right on him. So now Mimikyu, Bounsweet, and Popplio have been eliminated because of that series of events. seriously, why are you using a mop beware? That just makes no sense. So it looks like Team Rocket's about to win. When? What's gonna happen? Okay, Raichu's in the lead. With Pikachu, Mach Beware, and Nekowalla behind. I want Nekowalla to win, just because it would be the funniest. Don't go too fast, Pikachu. You'll lose your balance. Did the egg just glow a little bit? Nekowalla, what are you doing? What? It was just rolling on the ground. So now Wobbuffet and Meowth are burning up inside the costume. Oh no. So, a rocket-propelled tail. With the wheels, you can clearly see underneath. That suit's gonna fall apart, isn't it? Just the ridiculousness of that costume. Something's gonna fall apart right at the end. I just know it. The real Beware! And it takes off the head of the costume. Okay, Beware, those eyes. Just, the Beware just coming right in. Raichu and Pikachu stop in awe, and Nekowalla passes them rolling. Nekowalla wins! Oh, I was hoping that would happen. Oh my god! There's no words. There's nothing I could say to add to that. A bloody Nekowalla. That pincer looks so depressed. They keep focusing on that egg. I want it to hatch. Cocky, I appreciate your determination. Hello, random Sharpedo. But the race has been long over. You can stop now. Louis says there's a problem. The egg. The egg is glowing and radiating. Is it about to hatch? It hatched! And it was an Alolan Vulpix! Oh, that is beautiful. So now the question is, she's used to the egg. Can she handle the Vulpix? So, that is the end of episode 13. And from the bar, it looks like that's the furthest they've gotten to. So, wait, that makes it not a filler. That... Huh. The last minute and a half made it canon. Alright. So, that's it for this episode. It was just a nice little fun race. And then we got the egg hatching at the very end. That's, yeah. Yeah. So, that is it for episode 13. Next week is episode 14, I believe. So, now that I'm uploading again, I will be able to do something with that. So, until then, this is the Mad King Paradox signing off, and I will see you all then.